So here's the solutions to 2013 Leaving Cert business short questions. I'll be taking through the answers. So question one was to outline two characteristics of a private limited company. So there is a number of them here. Shareholders have limited liability, so they only lose the money invested in the business. No personal assets if a business goes bankrupt. So you only lose the money you invest and nothing else. There's one vote per share. So the more shares and the more votes at the AGM. Private limited companies have continuity of existence, which means that if a member or shareholder dies, the business keeps going. Separate legal existence. You must be invited to buy shares in a private limited company as well. So the person who owns the business must invite you in, whereas public limited companies, they're on the stock market. So there are different characteristics or features of private limited companies. Question two, the NCA, well, this has actually been replaced now, so it's no longer in effect. So the NCCA is now the CCPC, but the answer to that particular question is there. Very similar in terms of looking out for the welfare of consumers. Question three, you're asked to calculate the current ratio for Century LTD. So current ratio is current assets is to current liability. So looking at the question there, an asset is something that you own or is owed to you, and a liability is something that you owe. So you always want to have more assets than you do liabilities. So debtors, they owe us money. So that would be a current asset. A bank overdraft is owing money to the bank. So that's money owed. So that's a current liability. Cash is your money. So it's money you own. So that's a current asset. Creditors are people you owe money to. So that's a current liability. And closing stock, well, that's yours that you could sell to raise cash. So you own it. So that is also a current asset. So what you need to do here is you need to add up your current assets and you need to add up your current liabilities. So the debtors of 12,000, the cash of 15,000, and the closing stock of 8,000, you add them together and you get 35,000. And you add up the current liabilities, which is your bank overdraft, and your creditors, which is 70,000. So you have 35,000 to 70,000. So your answer there is 0.5:1. Now, the liquidity position of Century LTD. Well, the ideal situation a business wants to find themselves in is to have twice as many current assets as they do current liabilities. So your ideal is 2:1. Well, this is well below the ideal of 2:1. So Century LTD will not have enough short-term cash to cover debts as they fall due. So they'll have difficulty raising capital as they are not properly liquid. Okay, so it's a worrying position for them to be in, because if the business closed down tomorrow, they would owe that money and they wouldn't have enough current assets to cover it. So it's not a good position to be in. Question four, so there are true or false statements. So batch production is used when making single, one-off, and unique products. That's incorrect. That would be job production. So batch production is when you make, like bread, you make them in batches or a number of units at a time. Whereas job production, as I said, is single, one-off, unique products. In hire purchase agreement, legal ownership of the good transfers to the buyer when the first installment is made. That's incorrect. It's only when the last installment is paid does the person now own the product. Cash flow deficit can be addressed by negotiating a shorter period of credit with debtors. Yes, so debtors are people who owe us money. So if we have a deficit, in other words, we are spending more than we're taking in, if we give a less period of time to our debtors, it means they'll pay us earlier, which is beneficial for the cash flow forecast. A sole trader is an ownership structure that benefits from limited liability. That's incorrect. A sole trader has unlimited liability, which means they're responsible for all debts a business may have and may have to sell up personal assets to pay for them. When a company's equity capital is greater than its debt capital, it has low gearing. That is true. So equity capital is like your shares and debt capital is borrowing. So when you have more equity than debt capital, you are lowly geared. Two implications for management when a company develops its own website. So you can switch to an e-business, which is online. So customers can buy online. This can increase sales and market exposure 24/7. So your website is active 24/7. You know, not just store hours. Investment required for initial startup. So this could be costly. You're gonna have to train staff on use. You may have to buy a domain name to register your website. You may, you know, have to spend a lot of money on a number of areas in the business as well. So there will be investment required. So as you can see, there's one benefit there straight away and there's one challenge. In break-even analysis, distinctions made between fixed and variable costs. You need to explain these terms and give one example of each. So fixed costs, these are costs that remain the same regardless of level of sales, like rent. So the rent for the business will never change regardless of the level of sales, and that will have to be paid. Variable costs, they fluctuate or vary depending on the level of sales. like staff wages. So overtime would increase. You know, if there's more demands for your product, you're paying staff, you need more staff there, so you might have to pay more for that. So that would be a variable cost. Question seven, explain the term constructive dismissal. So the employee terminates the employment contract. This is illegal under the Unfair Dismissals Act of 1977 2007 because the employee feels that they're resigning due to unfair treatment if their employer of their employer towards them, but the employee has to prove it. So if they feel they've been bullied or harassed, for example, they can then argue constructive dismissal. This is part of Unit 1 Industrial Relations. Question 8, so you have terms and explanations, so you've got to match the correct term to the correct explanation. So the exchange rate is E, the price of one currency expressed in terms of another currency. Interest rate is F, the cost of borrowing. That may also be a savings related term as well, but for this question it's the cost of borrowing money. Taxation, that is D, so it can be progressive or regressive. Economic growth is A, the increase in the value of goods and services produced in the economy from one year to the next. And inflation is B, so it's measured by the consumer price index. Moving on to question 9, this is from unit 7, distinguish between a directive and a regulation as legislative instruments within the EU. So a directive is a law that each EU state must obey. So it's up to the national government to decide how to achieve a directive, but it must be done by a certain date. Whereas an EU regulation is a legal act which applies directly at national level. So when a regulation is approved, it comes directly into force. So countries do not bring about their own legislation for that. And question 10, outline two possible implications for a business if a manager adopts a McGregor's Theory X approach to managing. So remember, Douglas McGregor in 1960 in Unit 3 Motivation, he added two theories of motivation, an X and a Y. So the X basically, with that, they feel workers are only motivated by money. Managers feel workers are only motivated by money. So therefore, high staff turnover, staff do not enjoy work. So for the business, it could be impact on the training costs for the company. You'll have a demotivated workforce, no delegation, empowerment, being autocratic leadership, low morale, employees don't necessarily like working there either. So there is the answer to 2013 Leaving Cert Business short questions.